ways to hide everywhere that you go. You need someone you know you can't steal a kiss. In a place like this, how the rumors do fly in a town this size. In a smoking bar, in the back seat of your car, in your own little house, someone's sure to find you out. What you do and what you think, what you eat and what you drink. If you smoke a cigarette, we'll be talking about your breath. In a town this size, there ain't no place to hide. Everywhere you go, you need someone you know. You can't steal a kiss. In a place like this, how the rumors do fly. In a town. Oh, I had a fight with a girlfriend last night before the moon.
You gone. There you go. Hey, we're gonna see.
I heard a wood bus.
Thank you.
You want to raise that one up there? Boy, that's going to come off, eh?
Yeah, I got to take it. You want to see if we can get over a little more?
Yeah,
let me go back a bit more. Now, aha! Here's the corporate ready. Still spiked down here with the... Oop!
Yeah, okay.
Too much?
So what's your position with this railway?
I'm the vice president of the Clarenville Heritage Society.
Ah.
Steve is president, right?
Right on.
So usually just me, Steve.
Yeah.
Daryl Steele comes out from St. John's, and this year we got Adam that's helping us.
That's Adam.
That's Adam, man, hey?
Huh?
And what's Adam's position on this railway?
Board member.
So you're leading on that burr?
Leading on the burr, yeah. I guess I'm a... Board member, yeah.
There you go.
And I'm their chief media outlet.
Yes.
Oh, there you go.
That's like if people have seen before, Adam was the one responsible for like our Christmas, where we light up the engine. He made the packet and also made the telegram.
By the way.
So that's, Adam that does that for us, see?
She looked really good there the winter. I was going to come out and see her, but I got too lazy.
Well, yeah, she was a sight, I must say, yes.
They also carried the brand new speeder articles as well.
Yes, that's right, too. Which is a new speeder. This is why we're redoing this. So when we get the opportunity in the summer or Clarenville Day, we're going to start giving rides for people. Now, we're going to have to charge the price this year because our funds are not the same as they used to be.
No.
So we'd like to do it for free, but we can't.
Yeah.
So we're probably looking at probably like maybe $4, $5 for adult, two or three for a child, right?
Cool.
So we can see if we, and also it costs us to run the speeder too, right, with gas and...
Of course.
And then we got trying to do this, like I mean the bolts, spikes, I mean other things too, like I mean it's already cost us a fair amount of money to start this project, right?
And how much work did you guys have behind you here, pulling all that out, hiring all that?
Well, actually, we had one fella from our town council. He works with the town.
Yeah.
He volunteered his time after hours. Now, we had to sort of reimburse him a bit, me and Steve did.
Yeah.
So it really didn't cost the Heritage any money. It cost me and Steve money. The Heritage.
Hey, that cost somebody.
That's right. So, cool. I mean, that's what we got to do to
get
things done here right now, right?
Yeah. And what would you do to get more volunteers interested in this? How could you get more people interested, do you think?
I'm not sure, because that's the big problem here. Right? As you know, people I mentioned before, it wouldn't be possible without us three. It's usually us three. Now, my son was usually here, but this year he's involved with other projects.
Yeah.
And he can't make it.
Yeah.
But it was nice to see more volunteers here. The more we had, the faster we can have this built, right?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Right? I mean, I think we're doing pretty good so far today. I mean, we got...
Steve on the hammer down there.
Yeah, Steve's on the hammer. But we got one section almost done, and we're working on a second. So that's, look how long it took us last year to do in front of the station.
Yeah.
It took us, I think, 3 or 4 weekends.
Yeah. Yes, easy.
Right? And there's 4 of us.
Yeah.
Right?
Many hands make light work.
Yeah. So Steve, I can tell you're really enthused about getting this done.
Oh, very much so. Our goal is Clarenville Day.
Yeah.
Get as much down as we can. I mean, our ultimate goal is to put down 600 feet back to the place where the shed will be.
That's back there at that clearing, right?
Further on up.
Way back there, isn't it?
Good. Go for it.
You know something? If those cars weren't in the way, Honestly, they make some nice picture there. It's like you're building the railway across Newfoundland again. Yeah. The cars weren't there.
Yeah.
Take a picture of that and put it in black and white.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Really?
Oh, I know. They would.
You know, a little demonstration of what this one's like.
See, that's all right. Now, why has it got two there?
Huh? Steve, was that cart rebuilt last year when I was out?
It was, yeah. Put two top on it last year.
Yeah.
I put two spikes in, Charlie, for extra strength where we had that old bar, the railing.
Okay. No, I was just wondering what you're doing.
You wear the mask, Eve.
Oh,
boy. Today we're rebuilding history.
History of what?
I'm not sure. I'm still learning.
Newfoundland Hardwood's supply line. It's where they used to bring up the poles.
Okay.
From the hardwoods. And they used to bring up the poles along this line, and then they join it to see it farther up. The Plymouth that you seen earlier that we had used to haul up 5 cars of poles at a time from the hardwoods up to CN lines, and this is the main line they used to use. This is why we can rebuild it today, is because it's still part of the hardwoods, and we had special